Hi everyone, it's Angelica Borda, and today I'm going to be making two candles inspired by the series Julie and the Phantoms, which is now streaming on Netflix. Now, in order to really capture Julie's aesthetic, I'm going to be adding some purples and blues. These are the two main colors she uses on her outfits, as well as the lights that light her up when she's performing on stage. I'm so excited to get into these DIYs, so let's get on into it. For this first candle, you will need some soy wax flakes, a few popsicle sticks, super glue, a candle wick, a glass votive, 3 paper cups, scissors, a tape dispenser, 3 crayons of choice. We're going with blue and purple to match Julie and the Phantoms, and last but not least, a microwave. To start off, you're going to use the super glue and add that to the metal part of your wick. Stick that as close to the center as possible and hold it in place until you see that it's glued. Once your wick is secured to the bottom of your glass votive, you're just going to wrap your wick around a popsicle stick to keep it in center while you pour your wax. Now, in order to create your colored wax, you're just going to fill up a paper cup with a third of your soy wax flakes and then break up a crayon into that paper cup as well. Then you're going to go to the microwave and melt this up. Now you're going to repeat this process with all 3 of your crayons until you end up with a liquid consistency like this one. So here's where your tape dispenser comes into play. You wanna prop up your votive at an angle. That way when you pour your wax, it will only be in this corner of your votive. Each layer of wax takes about 30 minutes to dry. So after your first layer, you should end up with something that looks like this. So once your first layer is dry, you're going to prop it up on the other side and grab your next color of wax and add that into your votive. Now for this last and final layer of wax, you're just going to have your votive straight up and you're going to pour in your last color. Once your last layer is nice and dry, you're going to go ahead and cut off your wick to your desired length. That is it, guys. You have yourself a geometric candle. For this last candle, you would need an ice cube tray, your soy wax flakes, 2 crayons of choice, a few popsicle sticks, 2 paper cups, a tapered candle, and a pot with water for you to heat up. Now, by using the same technique that we used on our first candle, we will melt some of that soy wax flakes, add some crayon, and when you have that melted consistency, you'll pour it into one of these ice cube trays and you'll get some colored ice cubes, and that's what we're going to be using to make these tie-dye tapered candles. Next, you're going to heat some water in your pot. You wanna heat it enough for it to melt your wax cubes, but not to the point that it's actually boiling. Once your water is all heated up, you're going to take your wax cubes and just dump them into your pot. Once your wax cubes are melted in your water, you're going to take a spoon and stir it well. Then you'll take your tapered candle and dip it into your mixture. This is another reason why you don't want your water to be boiling, just hot enough to melt your wax cubes. If you need assistance with the dipping, please ask an adult. Now all that's really left for this candle is putting it on your candlestick holder and you're ready to go. I absolutely loved how these candles came out. They totally matched the Julie and the Phantoms vibe and they were so fun to make. I hope you replicate one of these at home. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.